The year is 1849, and a trio of immigrants.
Immigrants.
Has become stranded on their way to Independence, the fair beginning of the Oregon Trail.
Independence, Missouri.
Our wagon is stuck. We're low on supplies, and I think my leg is broken. If we don't get help soon, we're done for.
That's David's voice.
Who's this dude? Stranger.
Well, if it isn't a party of stranded greenhorns, my name is Moses Harris. Pleasant to be of assistance. Now let's take a look at what we're dealing with here.
Holy Moses.
Looks like you got some injuries. Who's in worse shape? Who should Moses Harris examine?
Who said the leg was broken?
David did, but I mean, ladies first?
Okay.
Yeah, ladies first.
Seems legit.
I'm a carpenter. I'm usually good at repairing wagons, but my arm is broken. Should Julia be treated with medicine? That wagon looks rightly broken.
Yeah, she can fix it if you fix her arm. But we don't know what David's shtick is yet.
David's just being a little whiny baby. Medicine can be used to restore health and recover from illness or injuries. Good to know. You're looking better already, Greenhorn. Better get that wagon moving again. Well, what are you waiting for? It isn't going to fix itself, you know. Dave is just all pissed off with a broken leg. But we got the wagon fixed, so
and he
now...
he jumped up in the air, so maybe he's okay.
I would think so. It's an improvement, but you should really take better care of your wagon in the future. Where are you going anyways? I really don't know. Oregon. It's the Oregon Trail. Oregon? Well, the trail starts in Independence. Not far from here. I'm heading that way myself. What do you say you join me? We're saved! Harris joins the party. Hell yeah, Harris. Something smells good. Is buffalo manure. Because that means buffalo are nearby, and then you can shoot it and kill it and cook it, and it's good. That's why buffalo manure would smell good. Don't make me explain myself. The pleasant scent of garlic. Okay. Of garlic, frying garlic and onions reaches the party long before the light of the cooking fires. That's a lot of people. Generous traveler.
Well, I'll be if it isn't Moses Harris. Still saving travelers on the trail, I see.
You're going to have to do some of these voices. I can't do them
all. Well, you just go into them. So I've just been... You look to be in a bad way. I'd be willing to sell you some supplies if you're interested. It's a good deal. Just $30.
Go ahead, Greenhorn. Saving money is only useful if you live to spend it. In exchange for their money, the woman hands over some toolboxes, clothes, coffee, and a harmonica.
And a harmonica.
I did not agree to this deal. I should teach you how to use those supplies. Let's try repairing your wagon first. Toolboxes can be used to repair wagon damage. Open the inventory to access your items and use... Actually, supplies and use items. Open the inventory. Bam. We got
the Resident Evil inventory style.
It is. Good observation.
We got 10 pigs.
We have 10 pounds of meat.
They're not pigs in a sack? Okay.
So that's like what? Like a 20th of a pig? How much does a pig weigh?
A lot.
So we got the toolbox. A box filled with the tools necessary for repairing the wagon damage. I pushed the button. Oh, it's...
Go to use.
It's being... All right, there we go. I pushed the wrong button. Oh, A is cancel. It's not select. It's cancel because that makes all the sense.
Yeah, that's confusing.
Did I just...
You used one toolbox. Okay, there's...
Oh, I thought I like threw it away or something. Much better. Now, is there anything else you want to learn about? About clothes. Trusting in clean clothes is the best way to combat poor hygiene and protect yourself from disease. Makes sense. Use clothes to restore 3 hygiene to an individual. Harris, you seem like a pretty damn sturdy dude. It didn't give me the option to pick Alfred first. I was going to pick Alfred first because he looked like he needed it. Harris is a sturdy guy who could probably go without a shower for like 3 years. Something better than coffee when you're low on stamina. Remember, if you push yourself too hard, you can become exhausted. Coffee. Use coffee to restore 2 stamina to the party. That's everybody.
So everybody gets stamina?
Everybody getting coffee turn. All right. And back to... the harmonica, sure. Good way to stave off. Low morale. You don't want to lose all hopes and become forlorn. Oh, no, not the forlorn. Single. Why would a harmonica be single use?
It's a really crappy harmonica.
Fair. Like, I know they're going for, like, more realism, more historical accuracy, but harmonicas...
They are more than one use.
Are more than one use. Yeah. Traditionally.
You look to be in much better shape now. Glad I could help. You're welcome to stay a while if you'd like to rest. The woman invites the group to join them for a meal.
I mean, I paid $30 for all that, so...
$30 is a lot of money in 1849.
Yeah, what would that be now, roughly? Best estimate, if you were to guess?
No clue.
A lot.
A few hundred dollars.
Yeah.
Like, $30... I mean, think about it. Like, $30 was a lot of money in the 1950s. So $30 in 1849?
More.
Yeah.
The party, accompanied by the other travelers, shares a delicious meal and tales of adventure. The food fills the party with vitality and fortifies them for the journey ahead.
I once fought a beaver for a fish. Stay a while, listen.
As the night draws on, the other party retires for the evening, and Harris explains how to survive on the trail. Harris is going to get a Deckard Cain voice for a little bit.
We best set out at first light. I know some spots nearby that are perfect for hunting.
Harris shows the Greenhorns his map, and together they plan a route for the day ahead. Choose our adventure. All right. Both are independents. Is it like the North Town Square and the South Town Square? It's what it looks like. The north side's got closer trees, which means... stuff. It's a hunting ground.
Food, pelts, needs bullets, but so is the deer, I think.
Area well known for its coyote population. Perfect opportunity to hunt for food. And the other one is the southern. Deer
pelts,
sounds more tasty than coyotes. We're going to go to the deer section. With plan in place, the party settles in for the night.
Farewell.
See, I wonder what would have happened if we had healed David and not Julia. Skunks.
David would be like pulling the wagon. I don't know. Like giving everyone piggyback rides or something. I don't know. Because his leg's all good.
Not all wildlife is for hunting. Experienced traveler can recognize all the different animals of the trail.
Collecting the... Why are we collecting animals? Tap an animal to record them in your journal and earn XP. You also enable automatically collect animals in the accessibility settings menu. Okay.
Ugh, that smell off.
Can I collect them skunks? How do I collect them skunks?
Okay, your cursor. How do you collect the skunks?
They go.
But it didn't tell us how to collect the skunks.
Party comes across an abandoned wagon.
Maybe it's just telling us you can.
Accompanied by a lonely oxen surrounded by scattered supplies.
Oh no.
Raided!
All of what Harris said was raided! You should probably take one of the wheels if you're confident in your carpentry skills. Better to have spare parts in case of accidents. Who should attempt to retrieve a spare wagon wheel? Julia, because she fixed the damn wagon. I feel like Julia is the only one that actually like has any capability of doing
skills.
Yeah.
This carpenter helps her retrieve the spare wagon wheel without any difficulty. Surprise, surprise. My mom Daniel's just like, look, all y'all.
You'll come across all sorts of situations as you travel. How you deal with them is up to you, but remember that your actions have consequences.
Dun, dun, dun.
Great power comes great responsibility.
There, up ahead.
There are animal tracks on the trail ahead. Stay close and stay quiet.
As we drag the wagon along on our...
Oh, yeah.
Adia!
Can we,
Adia. It's really a deer, not a doe, because it's got antlers. Oh, jeez. Oomph.
Hunting requires someone who's good at shooting and has plenty of stamina. So who? So make sure you send the right person. Who will try hunting? It appears Dave or Alfred has the bigger of the number, so Alfred will go shooting deer. Give me that gun, Harris. Take this little hunting rifle. Get dressed. Here, I'll even let you borrow my rifle and some ammunition. It's a little worn out, but you look great. It brings back some fond memories. Remember, you can only carry as much meat as your stamina allows. Only hunt what you need. Don't put the buffalo on the brink of extinction. And listen. Move the character. Press B to shoot. 2, 1, a go! We hunting.
He's coming right for us. He's coming right for us.
He's coming for us or coming right at us?
He's coming right at us.
Aww.
And he's at us.
That's a lot. Like, you can't carry that many deer.
He's... Wasn't coming. Ooh!
Oh, jeez.
He's coming right at us.
He was, like, moonwalking at you. Okay, this hunting is way easier than the hunting in the original game.
What do you mean, hunk of plate? I got one shot in him. He's going to bleed out. I get that buffalo, too.
I know. They're pretty big. They're pretty big. So you could carry 130 stamina minus one.
He tired. He pooped.
Yeah, I just don't know how you know how much you can carry.
Yeah, I never... Yeah, it was implying that there's only so much he could, but... Because
I know that's how it used to be.
After a hunt, it's always worth taking the time to skin your game properly. Lots of folks will pay top dollar for pelts. The fur trade is a big industry. Take it from me. I'm going to call it right now. Harris is the final boss of the game. It's like you roll up to the gates of Oregon, and there's Harris standing there with his rifle. There's only one way through, and it's through me. And it's a boss battle.
And then he has all of his copies run at you while you shoot at him.
Yeah. He uses some kind of something to make your character hallucinate, and you see six copies of him. You got to figure out which one's a real one. And take down the real Harris. Historically accurate. You got plenty of meat, so now's a good time to increase your rations. Besides, your party's rations can be changed at any time using the map. Open the map. Filling. Meager, bare bones.
Pace is steady, strenuous, and grueling.
How... No, we eating good. So there's bare bones. No, meager. But like more meager. Filling. There we go.
Filling. That's what you had, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So steady would be slowing the pace. Strenuous is medium.
Okay, so we will go at a steady pace because we will get there in one day regardless. And that's my inventory. Those are characters.
Oh, he's heroic. And
this is some section of the thing that we'll discover
figure out
later.
Was how to register the skunks.
Sorry, I had to do it.
You know, the stereotype of the old crazy gold digger is actually like a myth. It was usually really young dudes. That were out there, like, picture, like, your teenage brother and your uncle out there just digging around for gold.
Stay a while, listen, sonny!
Alright. 15 miles to Independence. Harris is feeling sick.
Well, that's not helpful.
Oh.
What?
He's got the
cholera.
Think I've come down with some kind of illness. I heard there's been an outbreak of the cholera recently. I gave you my last bottle of medicine, but I still have some herbal remedy that I made from local plants. Medicine and herbal remedies can be used on the party screen to recover health and treat illnesses or injuries.
Notice how he didn't offer to give that to Daniel. That's a broken leg.
That's because the broken leg's not a disease.
It said or injuries.
Oh, you're right. Oh, let's give it to David. Sorry, Harris, but you're holding out. We're giving it to David. that's what you get for lying to not being a truthful Tony. You could have, but you didn't. I really ought to see a doctor. We should hurry to Independence as soon as possible. Illnesses and injuries can be cured by visiting a physician at major settlements. Your party's walking pace can be changed at any time using the map. Open the map. We did see that we can do that, yeah. So, it's the same as the food. Regardless of how we do this, we will get there in one day. So, let's get Harris to the... What does it want me to do? Do you want me to be grueling? Let's be grueling. Is that what it wants? That's what it wanted. All right.
Wait, what? Did he get better or worse? It made a noise like it looked like he got better, but he couldn't get better.
Not sure.
That's where he got his cholera. From that there water...
Water whale?
Independence 3 miles. Then what's this?
I was going to say, it looks like we're definitely there.
Yeah, it do.
Are you saying that that building's like a mile wide?
There's the surgeon. There's the surgeon right there.
Oh, too late. He gone.
I mean, a surgeon also cut your hair and shit, but...
Nope, we're going over to Matt's General Store to get Matt's feel-good remedy. Here it is, Independence. This is where the Oregon Trail really begins. You can stock up on supplies at Matt's General Store and draft your own party of adventures at the saloon. You've learned a lot since the first match. You keep your chins up and think of the promising future that awaits you when you reach Oregon. I'll see you, Greenhorns. Harris bids the party farewell and disappears into the crowd because he will be the final boss. When we get to Oregon. Come on, old horse. Dude, like, you treat the cholera. I mean, damn. Bye, Harris. And that is the prologue. Congratulations, your party made it to Independence, the very beginning of the Oregon Trail. Many more immigrants like them will brave the trail in the years to come, dreaming of a new life in the Willamette Valley. But how many will succeed? Guidebook unlocks. Bam, bam. Begin your journey, which will start on the next episode. So thank y'all for joining us, which we're going to do right now, but we're going to pretend that this episode's ending because it really is ending, but we're going to keep going and it'll be a separate episode that will be in the future that we're doing now, if that makes any sense. Think on that. Until then, y'all be nice to each other.
And make good choices.
And we will see y'all right now.
And don't get cholera.
And don't get cholera.